Hello students, welcome to my YouTube channel. And this is the first lecture in real analysis. And in this video lecture, I'll be discussing the definition of what is a metric space and few examples which are based on metric spaces. So let us start this lecture from the definition of a metric space. So what is a metric space? For this, I will be considering X to be any non-empty set. Let x, y, z be any three arbitrary elements from the set X, right? So what is a metric? A metric is basically, so metric is nothing. It is a function, right? So a function D, right? Which is defined from X cross X, that is a Cartesian product, to the set of reals, right? Or we can even write R positive here. So this is said to be metric if and only if it satisfies few axioms. So is said to be metric if and only if it satisfies few axioms, and the axioms are, the first axiom is, that is the distance, that is the distance between any two points is always greater than or equal to zero, right? The second axiom is the distance between any two points is zero if and only if x is equals to y. The third property is the distance between x and y is equals to distance between y and x. And the last one is the triangle's inequality, which states that the distance between x and y is less than or equal to distance between x and z plus the distance between z and y. So this property is known as triangle's inequality. Similarly, third property is known as symmetric property. So basically, metric is nothing but a function which is defined from x cross x to R positive and which is satisfying these four axioms, right? So basically, this is calculating the distance between the two points. That is the motivation behind studying the metric space. Now let us discuss few examples and try to understand this definition. So the first basic example is a usual metric space. Is of a usual metric space. So when I say usual metric space, it means that when you are calculating the distance between two points, it is in a usual real line, that is a modulus of x minus y, right? So if I say R is a set of positive reals, is a set of positive real numbers, right? And D is a function which is defined from R cross R to R. And this D is a function. Now, this is a function, so I will be giving the definition for this function. So, in the domain, we are getting tuples. So, the distance between X and Y is given to us as modulus of X minus Y for all x and y belonging to R. Now I need to prove that this satisfies all the axioms of a metric space. So let us check if this is a metric or not. So the first property is you have to show that distance of between x and y is always greater than zero. Now since mod of a is always greater than equal to zero for all a belonging to R, right? So this implies modulus of x minus y is always greater than 0, which is nothing but d of xy is always greater than equal to 0, right? So coming to the second property. So the second property was the distance between x and y is 0 if and only if x is equals to y. So distance between x and y is 0. Now what is distance between x and y? That is modulus of x minus y is 0. So when this thing holds, if and only if, so I'll be using if and only if here, x minus y is 0, mod of something is 0, it means that something is 0. So this implies x minus y is 0. Now x minus y is 0 if and only if x is equals to y. So we have proved this result both the ways, because that is what our second property expected from us. Now moving on to the third property, that is the distance between x and y must be equal to distance between y and x. Now you know that either you calculate the distance of mod of x minus y or you calculate the distance of mod of y minus x, that is one and the same thing. Why? Because you can take out minus common from this. So if you take minus common, so you are left with y minus x mod, right? Now you can split the modulus. So modulus of minus 1 into modulus of y minus x. And modulus of minus 1 is nothing but again 1. And this is mod of y minus x, which is nothing but distance of yx. So symmetricity also holds. And the fourth property, that is triangles inequality, which is very important. So let us prove that. Now, in order to prove the triangles inequality, what I am interested to prove is that is the distance between x and y must be less than or equal to distance between x and some point z plus distance between z and y. Now we know that distance between x and y is nothing but modulus of x minus y. Now you can add and subtract z in this. So this will be x minus y plus z minus z, right? So now you can just combine the terms, that is x minus z, right, plus z minus y. Now we know that because mod of a plus b is always less than or equal to mod a plus mod b for all a b coming from reals. So just using this inequality, I can write it down. This is less than or equal to mod of x minus z plus mod of z minus y. And what is mod of x minus z? This is nothing but distance of x and z. And what is mod of z minus y? That is the distance between z and y. So we have proved that the distance between x and y is less than or equal to distance between x and z plus the distance between z and y. And hence, it satisfies all the axioms of a metric space. So D is a metric on R, which is called a usual metric on R, right? And R along with D is said to be a usual metric space, right? So one more thing which I would like to add up here is that D is referred as distance function sometimes, right? And since D of xy is any non-negative real number, so this is called the distance between x and y. So this is called as a distance between x and y, right? And this set x together with the metric D is said to be a metric space. So I hope now the definition of metric space along with this example is clear to you. So moving on to one more example. So now let us consider the example of a discrete metric space. The discrete metric space is defined as D of xy is 0 whenever x is equals to y, and D of xy is 1 whenever x is not equal to 1. And I need to check that this is a metric space or not. So in order to check metric space, the first property is that D of xy must be greater than or equal to 0. You can observe here that the value of D of xy is either 0 or 1. So this thing is greater than or equal to 0. So the first axiom is satisfied. Second axiom, D of xy is equals to 0 if and only if x is equals to y. This thing also you can observe from the definition that D of xy is 0. This thing hold whenever x is equals to y, and also the converse way. Now for third part, what I need to show is that is the distance between x and y is equal to the distance between y and x. So in order to prove this thing, I'll be considering two cases. Case 1, when x is not equal to y, and case 2, when x is equals to y. So let us discuss the case when x is not equal to y. So in case if x is not equal to y, it means the distance between x and y is nothing but 1, right? And distance between y and x, so just replace y with x and x with y in this definition. So again, the answer is 1, and 1 is equals to 1. So this thing is true. Similarly, if x is equals to y, the distance between x and y is 0, and distance between y and x is also 0. So this thing is again true. So the third property satisfied. Moving on to the fourth property, the fourth axiom, that is the triangles inequality. So in order to prove triangles inequality, I'll be taking various cases here. Let us consider three arbitrary elements x, y and z coming from the non-empty set x, right? So the first case is when x is equals to y is equals to z, right? In that case, the distance between x and y is equals to distance between x and z is equals to distance between z and y. Why? Because all of them will be 0. So in this case, you can say that the distance between x and y is is exactly equal to distance between x and z plus distance between z and y, because 0 is equal to 0 plus 0. Now coming to the second case, when x is equals to y, but this thing is not equal to z. So in this case, you can observe that the distance between x and y will be 0, right? Because x and y are equal. Fine. Now, what is the distance between x and z? X and z are distinct elements, so their images will be 1. And what is the distance between y and z? That is again, y and z are distinct, so it will be 1 again. Now, let us see whether it satisfies the triangle's inequality or not. D of xy must be less than or equal to d of xz plus d of yz, right? So 0 is less than or equal to 1 plus 1. So this thing is true. So the second case also holds, the first case also holds. Now let us move to the third case. The third case is x is not equal to y, but this thing is equal to z. So you can see that the distance between x and y will come out to be 1 in this case, and the distance between y and z is 0, and the distance between x and z in this case is 1. So again, this satisfies the triangle's inequality. Why? Because the distance between x and y must be less than or equal to distance between x and z plus the distance between y and z. And distance between x and y is 1, and 1 is exactly equal to 1 plus 0. So the third case is also true. Let us discuss the fourth case. The fourth case is when x is not equal to y and y is also not equal to z. So in that case, the distance between x, y is also 1. The distance between y and z is also 1. And the distance between z and x is also 1. So now let us check the triangle's inequality. That is, the distance between x and y must be less than or equal to distance between x and z plus the distance between y and z. So 1 must be less than 1 plus 1. So 1 must be less than 2. So this thing is true. So in each of the cases, we have observed that the distance between x and y comes out to be less than or equal to distance between x and z plus the distance between z and y, right? For all x, y and z coming from x. So you can say that therefore D is a metric on x, right? And x along with D is called a metric space, and to be precise here it will be called discrete metric space, because we have named it as a discrete metric space in the beginning. So now in my upcoming video lectures, I will be discussing few more examples of metric spaces and few more inequalities which are required to prove metric space. So I hope you have understood this video lecture. For more such video lectures, subscribe to my YouTube channel and do not forget to press the bell icon.